Now let's talk about bradycardia. Absolute bradycardia is defined as a pulse rate less than 60 beats per minute. During the patient assessment, it's important to determine whether life-threatening signs and symptoms are present that are caused by that bradycardia. Bradycardia can present itself in several different cardiac rhythms to include sinus bradycardia and varying degrees of AV heart blocks. Regardless of the rhythm, if the heart rate is too slow and the patient has symptoms from the slow rate, then the bradycardia should be treated to increase the heart rate and improve perfusion. For a patient that is asymptomatic, we will continue care with close monitoring and choose which appropriate care should be given. The primary treatment for symptomatic bradycardia includes the following: to administer supplemental oxygen if the pulse oximetry is below 94%, and be sure to establish an IV. We're going to want to monitor the ECG rhythm as well. We will want to obtain a 12-lead EKG as soon as possible, but let's not delay therapy to get a 12-lead. The medication to be given will be atropine, 1 mg via rapid IV push to increase the heart rate. If atropine is ineffective, then we may need to consider transcutaneous pacing. If serious signs and symptoms such as unresponsiveness are present, transcutaneous pacing would be the first line treatment rather than attempting atropine. Other medications to be considered would include epinephrine infusion at 2 to 10 micrograms per minute or dopamine infusion at 5 to 10 micrograms per kilogram per minute. Remember that with conscious patients who need transcutaneous pacing, sedation may be a good idea to help alleviate the discomfort. Some patients may present with relative bradycardia. This is when the heart rate is over 60, but the patient presents with low blood pressure or a decreased level of consciousness. The same interventions would be required as a patient with absolute bradycardia.